Hello everyone. So we all know what are ideal and non-ideal solutions. So in the first we will take the ideal solutions, and the secondly we will take the non-ideal solutions. So a solution which obeys Raoult's law under all conditions of temperature and concentration can be taken as ideal solution. So a solution which do not obey Raoult's law under all conditions of temperature and concentration can be taken as a non-ideal solution. So in this ideal solution, delta H of mixing is equal to 0, and in case of non-ideal solution, the value of delta H of mixing is not equal to 0. It may be either positive or negative. So thirdly, so the delta V of mixing will be 0 in case of ideal solution. In case of non-ideal, delta V of mixing is not equal to 0. So in case of ideal solution, the intermolecular force of attraction in the individual liquids will be same as that of the intermolecular force of attraction present in the solution. So in case of non-ideal solution, the intermolecular force of attraction of the individual liquids is different from that of the solution. So next we will study what are the different types of non-ideal solutions. So there were two different types of non-ideal solutions, that is non-ideal solution with positive deviation and the non-ideal solution with negative deviation. So what are the characteristics of these non-ideal solutions with the positive and negative deviation? Firstly, non-ideal solution with positive deviation, it will show positive deviation from Raoult's law. Any solution shows positive deviation from Raoult's law can be taken as a non-ideal solution with positive deviation. Similarly, if any solution shows negative deviation from Raoult's law, we can say that solution is a non-ideal solution with negative deviation. So in case of non-ideal with positive deviation, the value of delta H of mixing is positive. So what's the meaning of that? So during the mixing up of the two liquids, there is increase in the heat change produced. There is increase in the heat change produced. That means heat is gained by the system. Hence, the value of delta H of mixing is equal to positive. So, in case of non-ideal with negative deviation, delta H of mixing is negative. So, what's the meaning of that? So, during the mixing up of the two liquids to form a solution, the heat is lost by the system. So, system will lose some amount of heat due to the mixing up of the two liquids to form a solution. So hence delta H of mixing is negative. So next, the third difference is delta V of mixing is equal to positive. So what's the meaning of this? So during the mixing up of the two liquids to form a solution, the volume of the solution obtained by the two liquids addition will gets increased. That is, increase in the volume takes place by the mixing up of the two liquids to form a solution. So hence delta V of mixing is positive. So here delta V of mixing is negative in case of non-ideal with negative deviation. So why? Because during the mixing of the two liquids, there is a decrease in the volume takes place. Okay. So hence delta V of mixing is negative. So the fourth difference is the intermolecular force of attraction in individual liquids is greater than the solution in case of non-ideal solution with positive deviation. So what's the meaning of that? So in case of a non-ideal solution with positive deviation, the particles gets attracted with one another in case of individual solution and also individual liquid and also solution. So in case of individual liquids, the force of attraction is more compared to the particles present in the solution. So due to the less force of attraction between the particles present in this solution, so these particles present in the solution are trying to escape out of the solution. As a result, the pressure of the liquid present in the solution gets increased by comparing with the value obtained from the Raoult's law, so that the PA is greater than P0A into XA. Similarly, for the liquid B, PB is greater than P0B into XB. So these equations are obtained only based on this fourth difference, that is intermolecular force of attraction in individual liquids is greater than the intermolecular force of attraction present in the solution. So in case of solution, the particles are held together by weak force, so that those particles are trying to escape from the out of the solution. So as a result, the pressure gets increased by comparing with the pressure obtained from the round stone. Hence, PA is greater than P0 A B X U and PB is greater than P0 B2 X B. So based on that, so if we go through the curve of the paper pressure along Y axis and mole fraction along X axis, so this kind of curve is obtained for the ideal solution, which does not deviate from the round slab. So such kind of solution will show some straight lines which passes through the origin lines. So if the solution is showing positive deviation from round slab, so here PA is greater than P0 A into XA, PB greater than P0 B into XB. So for that, we are going to get some other positively deviated curves. So this is the curve according to the round slab. A solution which is obeying round slab will give a straight line. Since it is showing positive deviation from round slab, we are going to get a curve, positive deviation from this round slab. So this line represents PA greater than P0 A into XA. Similarly for the liquid B, so this is a liquid B curve. And if for an ideal solution, we are going to get a straight line which passes through the origin. Whereas for a non-ideal solution with positive deviation, we are going to get a positively deviated curve like this from the line obtained from the ideal solution. So ideal solution shows any no deviation, whereas the non-ideal solution with positive deviation shows positive curve from the ground slab. So this line represents PB greater than P0B into XB. So the resultant of this line is PT is equal to P0A plus P0B. So this is for ideal solution. Since it is a non-ideal solution with positive deviation, we get a positively deviated curve, so that PT greater than P0A plus P0B. So these are nothing but the type of curves obtained for a non-ideal solution with positive deviation. If we draw a graph of partial pressure of the liquid A and liquid B along Y axis and the mole fraction along X axis. Similarly, in case of non-ideal solution with negative deviation, the intermolecular force of attraction of individual liquids is less compared to the solution. Since the solution containing particles are held together by a strong force of attraction, so that the particles will not move, or particles present in the solution, they are very much rigidly bounded, so that only few particles will move from liquid into the vapor pressure, so that the pressure obtained is less compared to the pressure obtained from the round slab. That is, PA is less than P0A into XB, XA, and for the liquid B, PB is less than P0B into XB. So, based on this equation, the relation, we are going to draw a graph of mole fraction versus partial pressure. So, if the solution shows ideal behavior, we are going to get a straight line passes through the origin. So if since the solution is showing negative deviation from the ideal behavior, for the liquid A, we are going to get one of the curve which shows negative deviation from this round slab curve. Okay, so this is according to round slab for an ideal solution. So from this solution, this solution is deviating from this ideal behavior. So this curve represents PA less than P0 A into XA. Similarly, for the liquid B also, we are going to get a negatively deviated curve. So this curve represents PP less than P0B into XB. So the total pressure obtained can be taken as the PT less than P0A plus P0B. So these kind of curves are obtained for the non-ideal solution with the positive and negative deviation. So once again, we will differentiate the we will study the characteristics of non-ideal solution with positive and negative deviation. So, in case of non-ideal with positive deviation, it shows positive deviation from Robertson, that solution shows negative deviation from Robertson. So, here delta H of mixing is positive and delta H V of mixing is also positive. So, in case of non-ideal with negative deviation, so here we have mentioned negative, these two are also negative in nature. Here it is positive, these two are positive in nature in case of non-ideal with positive deviation. So, delta H of mixing is negative and delta V of mixing is negative in case of non-ideal with negative deviation. So, the fourth difference is the intermolecular force of attraction in individual liquids is greater present in the compared to the solution. So, in case of solution, the particles are held together by a weak force of attraction. As a result, those solution particles are trying to escape from the surroundings, so from the solution into the outside, so that the pressure obtained is greater compared to the pressure obtained from the Robertson. Hence, we get PA greater than P naught K into XA and PB greater than P naught B into XB. So, based on this condition, we are going to get a positively deviated curve from the Robertson. Similarly, in case of non-ideal with negative deviation, the intermolecular force of attraction in individual liquids is less compared to the solution. So, in case of solution, particles are held together by a strong force of attraction so that only few particles will move from liquid into vapor state, so that the vapor pressure gets reduced by comparing with the pressure obtained from the Robertson. So, based on these two conditions, we are going to represent the graph like this for a non-ideal solution with negative deviation. That means, so if a solution is showing ideal behavior, we are going to get a straight line passes through the origin. So, if a solution showing positive deviation from Robertson, we are going to get a positively deviated curve. And if a solution showing negative deviation from Robertson, we are going to get negatively deviated curves.